Up until recently, PIML could only send data to one PI server. So, if there was a collective, you had to use some type of workaround such as PI-to-PI to make sure that data got to all members of the collective. In the past, BuffSS and BuffServe only supported API buffering. What this meant was any applications that were SDK-based rather than API-based did not have this option. PI Manual Logger is a PI SDK application. Therefore, it can't take advantage of these API buffering mechanisms. With the release of PI SDK 1.40, buffering was introduced. This allowed that same fanning of data, but from PI SDK applications such as PIML. To be able to take advantage of PI SDK buffering, it must be configured on the box at which PIML resides. Let's look at that configuration now. PISDK buffering is configured through the AboutPI-SDK application. I go to the Start menu, All Programs, PI System, and I'll find that AboutPI-SDK is within my PI System menu group. I'm going to open that now. As I look across the top, there's a PISDK buffering menu option and one specifically for configuration. I'll select that. Here I'll see there's a status bar that tells me whether PISDK buffering is active or not. In this case, it's not. I can use this box to enable it. And then also I have a drop-down to select which collective I want to fan data to. I choose this and then do a save. I'll notice my status is updated now. PI buffer subsystem is now buffering to my collective. All that I need to do from this point is go and use any of my normal data entry methods in PIML. Once data is sent to PI, it will be fanned to all members of this collective via the PISDK buffering.